Noah. I grew up going to church, hearing singing like that. I grew up as a preacher's kid. Got some preacher's kids here. Security. Had the youth group coming around my house all the time. And there was this Thursday night prayer meeting. It was people with hair coming out of their nostrils, chasing me around the coffee table, trying to lay their hands on me. And you laugh. Every time somebody came to our church and preached about heaven and hell, I'm sure I gave my life to Jesus about 750 times a month. And you know, I made my way from Sunday school through the youth group and to the front of the church. I had this fire burning inside of me. But after years, I realized that I begin to walk away from the things of my faith. I begin to stop reading the word. I begin to stop hanging out with people who believe the same. It was like that fire just began to disappear. And you know, I kind of believed that Jesus was the way, but I began to feel lost. And I believed he was the truth, but I was full of half-truth. And I believed he was the life, I think, but I hadn't found that life that he came to give me. And you know, if you'd asked me at the time if I was a Christian, I would have said yes. But I never acted like one, never loved like one, never forgave like one, never spoke like one or thought like one. And after a while, whatever foundation I had began to erode. Every storm that came, I was blown to the left and to the right. And I made my way from the front of the church to out the back door. And I got to a place of just utter confusion, not knowing, do I believe this because I was raised this way, born in the West? Do I believe this because I'm a preacher's kid? If I was born somewhere else, would I believe it? And a dangerous place for us to get in life is when we don't know exactly what we believe, because then we'll end up believing anything. And I tell you tonight, it was by the grace of God. Again, just remembering a couple of scriptures from Sunday school that came back at me. One of them was where God said, if you draw near to me, I'll draw near to you. And I hadn't really done that. Or call to me and I'll answer you and show you great and marvelous things that you don't know. I hadn't really done that. But I began to cry out to God. God, if you're the creator of the heavens and the earth, then I want to get to know you. I don't want any old religion. And it didn't happen straight away. But something did begin to start to change in my life. I remember I began to see the love of God, and how I saw the love of God was seeing what he hated. I began to see that back in the beginning, when he created the heavens and the earth and mankind, he had a wonderful plan. But something came in and entered. The works of something wicked that was never meant to be. And I begin to see that God hates that. You see, because the works of that wicked thing are why the world is in a mess today. It's why we have sickness and disease, poverty, hurt and pain. And them works that I'm speaking of are very, very powerful. You think about something so powerful, it can separate us from God. That's how powerful it is. Something so powerful that it breeds anger, hatred, and bitterness, and malice. something so powerful it'll cause a man to kill another man. And I begin to see that the only way that this thing could be dealt with is for something more powerful to overcome it. Science can't do it. Philosophy can't do it. Medicine can't do it. Religion can't do it. The only thing that can do it is something more powerful than it. And the only thing more powerful than it is something that has defeated death. And the only thing that's defeated death is Jesus Christ, the Son of God. You see, this is the hope. This is my hope. This is the hope for mankind that a bridge has been there now for us between man and God. But ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you tonight, there's another separation coming. Far greater than the first. There's a time coming where some will head one way for all eternity to a place that was never meant for us to be. In fact, it was created for the devil and his angels. And there's a time coming where some will head the other way and they will see what God had intended right from the beginning. And you know, when that time comes for me, I will not be entering heaven because I went to Sunday school, nor because I was in the youth group or born in the West, or because I'm a preacher's kid. I will not be entering heaven because I sing songs about my faith or that I preach the name of Jesus around the earth. It's not enough. But when that time comes for me, I'm going to need someone who's got my back. I'm going to need someone who's got my back, not any old prophet, not any old priest, not any old king, not any old lord, but I'm going to need someone who has defeated the last enemy, my last enemy, death. And that is only one. The way, the truth, the life, Jesus Christ. Let's all bow our heads and close our eyes. I want to give you an opportunity here tonight. You might be here and you don't know if that gap between you and your Creator has been bridged. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Eternity is a long time. Jesus says, I stand at the door of your heart and I knock. Tonight you can make a decision like I did. If you're here tonight while no one's looking around and you want to make Jesus your Lord and Savior, I want you to raise your hand just real quick. That's great. Keep them up. It's a statement of faith saying, yes, Jesus, I believe you're who you said you are. I know there's some here tonight that you feel like you've committed some sin that's made you unforgivable. Let me tell you, that's a lie from the enemy of your soul. God said in his word, if you turn and repent, he is just and able to forgive. I want you to raise your hand tonight too. That's great. Keep them up. And finally, Jesus said, if you deny me before men, I will deny you before the Father. But he said, if you acknowledge me before men, I will acknowledge you before the Father. Just a few more seconds. Raise your hand. Don't let this moment pass you by. Right, you can put them down. Let's all pray this prayer together. Dear Lord Jesus, I believe you're the Son of God. And you came to this earth and died for my sins and rose again so that I might have life. Forgive me of my sins. Come into my heart. Be my Lord and Savior. I pray these things in your precious name. And everybody said,